Today I am going to talk about Web 2.0 LSC platform project. My name is Ebra. I am working at Twitter marketing about 4 years as a grid specialist and operation manager. We have two telco centers in Turkey. One of them is for CMS experiment and the other is for the Atlas experiment. I am managing both for two centers in Turkey. And this is my outline. Firstly, I would like to introduce our customers, who we are, and our infrastructure and main projects. Then our expertise. After that, I will give a brief introduction about the grid computing. Actually, grid computing is a very large topic. Therefore, I can just a brief introduction about the grid computing technology because of the time restriction and the architecture and the applications. And then WRCG works by Large Hot Hadron Collider Computing Group, TRS of WRCG. And finally, a brief introduction to interact things with grid modelways, grid job management. In this, at my presentation, if you are interested how a large amount of data which is produced by Large Hadron Collider analyzed with the minute number of scientists, you will get answer. And the final session, I will give you example of the interacting with the grid middleware, grid job management. The data management also is possible. Or if you are a member of CMS or Atlas, you can ask question after the presentation. It might be about, for example, Gambia or the future that we for Atlas experiment, or TRAP or FedEx for data transfer. If you have question about this topic, you can ask. I will be here during the day, then I will return back to Ankara. And who we are? TÜBİTAK is the acronym of the Scientific and Technological Research Council of Turkey. It is an autonomous institution and governed by scientific board. It has about 15 different research institutes in Turkey. And the main sponsor is the national coordinating body of European Framework Program. And Blockchain is my institute, the National Academic Network and Information Center. It is one of the institutes of ITAC. The major responsibilities for managing national grid initiatives and infrastructure, and also managing national academic network. Managing both these infrastructures provides a convenient environment because in the grid computing side, you also need help from people at the academic network. Both of the people are located at the same altitude, and whenever required a change, it is easy to perform this task. And finally, acting necessary for academic participation. And TRGRID initiative was established in 2003 between TÜBİTAK and the Polish University. Then the participation of the other universities was expanded. After this, we have involved some European projects. For example, SIGREC is one of them. It's a kind of regional European project. Covers the southeastern European countries. And SIGREC, SGR, UMIC, GRID, EG, and now EGR are the other projects we are involved. And we are coordinating national grid related activities in Turkey. And these are the certified sites exist in the EGI infrastructure. black team is the newest cluster. It has about 6,000 cores with 30 terabytes storage. And Meteor and TR10 black beam are the other sites for the CERN experiment. And the other sites are small sites, which are certified UNGI. And these are the HPC sites. The national HPC users can also utilize other computing centers by using single user interface. And this is the number of the resources besides that. And these are the our projects, major projects. The first one is CERN experiments. Both Atlas and Siemens are supported with two production center. And these numbers are the dedicated numbers in this year. It's about 10,000 head space. The 100 kilobyte storage are provided for CERN experiments now. And these are the other projects with support, earth science, seismology, meteorology, network flow, and individual users application. These are the our projects. And our head studies, as I said before, TR10 locked in for the Atlas experiment, and TR3 missile meant for the Siemens experiment. And this table shows the defines shows the computing and storage resources that defined in the MOU understanding agreement document. We are now providing this computing and storage resources for the CERN experiment. And now I would like to introduce all of you to grid computing. In grid computing, it has a similar idea with the World Wide Web. World Wide Web, as all of you know, is used commonly over the world for many years. By entering URL information at the browser, you can reach the information. It is users uses it to share information. On the other hand, in the grid computing side, internet is used to share computing power. It means that there is a computing power located anywhere in the world, and you can use the internet, and by using internet you can access this computing power. And the purpose is forming a global network of computers that can be operated as a single vast computational resource. As you can see in the pictures, there are many computing resources, and all of them are connected to each other by the internet. And actually, in a standard HPC model, there was already the spark computing or the national computing centers are not a new technology. There were already exist in 1990s. And the users can utilize one of these computing resources by opening an account and connect them to the front-end system. In the grid model, grid computing model, these computing centers are integrated to each other. And a researcher can use multiple computing centers by using a single sign-on. It means that by using your personal computer, you can reach a minimum number of computing centers which are located over the world. And what is the main idea behind the grid computing? Actually, it is very similar to electrical power at home. When you are at home, you can, for example, plug into your computer and use the computing resources. It is not important for you where the computing power is located and how it works. It is not your job. Grid computing is similar. And the main purpose is the grid computing is the resource sharing. global research sharing. The users or the scientists who have the common challenge can access, can share the remote computing and storage resources as well as software and data. Actually, these are not only the shared components are not only related to computing devices, but also you can they can also share remote sensors, telescopes, and other devices. Especially with the improvement on the network technology, a large amount of data can be sent to another sensor and can be analyzed. As ALC example, for example, in the ALC, there are terabytes of data. It can be moved by another computing center by a user. Grid computing enables the users to perform this kind of operation. And this is the real-time monitoring. The circles show the computing centers. As you can see, they are distributed over the world. And the lines between the circles show the data transfer. Real-time monitoring is a tool that monitors the grid activities on the infrastructure and reacts to the bottlenecks in the grid in real time. I am showing this slide. If you're interested, you can have a look. But the problem is suitable for grid computing. The answer is high throughput programs. It means that if you have a large scientific problem, and this large problem can be divided into a number of independent tasks, and it can be done in a different computing processors, it means that your problem is suitable for the grid computing. It is possible to perform hundreds or thousands of tasks simultaneously. And what are the examples? most of the examples is the Large Hadron Collider. It can be analyzed of thousands of particle collisions at the same time. Another example is the Wiesmann project. It analyzes the of thousands of molecules to discover a new drug. And these are the other kind of applications. Grid computing is not used by only ALC experiments. There are many number of scientists from the other disciplines. Biology, earth science, astrophysics, fusion and computational chemistry are just one of them. And grid computing for ALC, it is not possible to process the large amount of data on a single sensor. Therefore, it requires to integrate a number of computing centers to process this data. Before, most of universities and institutes had already computational power. And the great question is here, could it possible to integrate these facilities provide a single NSC computing services with the remarkable improvement on the wide area network, it should be possible. And these metrics show the technological improvement on the computational side. And the result shows that network become faster and individual computers become powerful. As a result, grid concept becomes more feasible for the large problem, for example, ALC. And worldwide, ALC computing grid. As I said before, ALC experiment uses the grid computing environment. Worldwide, WRTP is the global collaboration linking to hundreds of data centers worldwide. Enables researchers to analyze 15 petabytes of data annually generated by SC. And this distributed computing infrastructure, and no matter where the resources are located, and it enables 8,000 scientists around the world can access and process the LSC data. And WNCG is the largest grid computing over the world. It's based on two main projects. The first one, EGI. It is a grid infrastructure. It's installed in Europe. And the other one is the OCG, Open Science Grid, in the United States. It is a shared architecture. At the center of the circle, there is a one shared zero center. And around this center, there are a number of tier 1 centers and tier 2 centers. here, I would like to mention about tier 0 center. There is only a single tier 0 center, which is called CERN Computer Center. All data from the LSC passes here and provides less than 20% of the total computing capacity. And the responsibility is the first copy for the raw data and reconstruction data, then distribution of the data to TR1 centers. It is important to connectivity speed up between these centers because there are large amount of data transferred between them. And TR1 center currently about 11 tier 1 centers are available. These are the large computer centers with the sufficient storage and computing capacity. Their responsibility is storage proportional shape of raw and reconstructed data comes from tier 0 center and provides large scale reprocessing and storage generated output. And furthermore, distribution data to TR2 centers and storage simulation and analysis data which is produced on the TR2 centers. And these are the list of the TR1 centers over the world. And TR2 centers, 140 TR2 centers are available now. Typically, universities and scientific institutes can install a TR2 center. Their responsibility is storing sufficient data and providing adequate computing power and handling proportional share of simulations, event production and reconstruction. And finally, there are TR2 centers, but there is no formal engagement between WRCC and TR2 centers. Also, if you use your national TR2 centers as a batch system, you can also call it a TR2 center. And here, I would like to show how to interact with the grid middleware. Actually, there are many ways to use grid middleware API. I am sharing with you, grid job management, but I will not cover data management on the grid computing because the time is very restricted. And also, as I said before, Gambia or DQ2 tools are not covered in this session. But if you have a question about this topic, you can share with me. You can ask me. And here, before interacting with grid middleware, there are some requirements you should perform. Firstly, you need to install a SSH client. If you use a Windows operating system, or Windows copy might be a suitable solution for you. Or if you use Linux operating system, you can use terminal to connect user interface in the grid computing. And for sure, you need to have an account on the user interface. Then you need to grid certificate. To do that, you are required to apply a grid certificate on the certification authority. And after obtaining the grid certificate, you need to generate private and public keys. then you are starting to be a member of the Renewable Future Organization. It might be the CNS or Atlas Future Organization. Then you are creating policy and that you can interact with the great computing environment. You can send jobs and monitor the status of the job, or you can build the data in the great computing. And here I would like to share some kind of comments on the great computing. The first one is the generating private and public keys. After applying green certificate, you will have an email that shows the your certificate with the P12 extension. By using this file, you are required to generate private and public key. OpenSSL is the OpenSSL command is using for this purpose. Then finally, you need to set permission of the files properly. And to check what it will do, you can use recite info. This command gives information about your certificate. What is your certification authority, your name, and most importantly, the validation time of your certificate. Can be created by this command. And here's how you can create a proxy. There are a great number of computing resources available in Grid Computing, but to use them, you should be authorized to utilize these resources. One proxy init command can do it, but the validation time is for 20 hours. To extend this time, you need to require use myproxy command. After you create a proxy, you can query the proxy with the forms proxy info command. And the last of the slide, you can see the command and the output of the command. As you can see on the last line, it shows the validation time of your proxy. And now you have to submit your job, but before submitting your job, you should decide the following points. Firstly, you should be decided to which executable or which code will be submitted to which environment, and which data will be used, and the amount of data will be sent is important with this, because if you analyze a small part of data, it is not required to use a data management command. But if you analyze a large amount of data, for example, terabytes of data, you need to know data management command or some specific tools for the Atlas or CMS users. For Atlas users, the G2 is most common used in the world. On the other side, for the CMS side, FedEx is used to transfer terabytes of data. And finally, you should know whether the executables are dependent on the operating system or user. Because the user interface you use is not the same as remote computing resources. And job description language, it defines the properties of your job. These are the main metrics you should know. The first one is job type. You should define what is your job type. Is it normal or interactive, or is it based on APIs or checkpoints? Then executable, that the command is the executed, and arguments defines the arguments passing to command. And standard input, standard output, or standard error shows the input and output files after submitting your job. And these are the environments that required to define environment variable. And the final one is the requirements. It's an important this, because if you have application that has a specific requirement, for example, operating system, or a library you need to use, you should specify here by setting the requirements in the JDM file. And this is a very basic example of job description language. In here, you are running a hello world C code to remove computing power. In the SH file, you are compiling the C files and runs, and the input sample, you are specifying which input files are, and in the output sandbox, you are specifying which the output files in the job. And this is the appropriate size. As I said, you are defining your job properties with the JDR file. And there are minimum number of size available for this kind of job. So this of the appropriate size, you will use glibc EMS job mismatch command with the passing your JDR file. Here is the result of this command. As you can see here, the computing IDs of the appropriate size are listed. And you can also specify one of the computing elements in the your job file with the settings requirements parameter. For example, in this example, your job will be sent the JR working goals here. If you are not setting these parameters, the workload management system in the VMS selects one of the sites for you. And these are the commands of grid job management. To submit the job, GLAP VMS job submit command is used. Bio parameters defines which organization is used. If you are Atlas member, you will set Atlas or CMS application. And if you want to monitor the status of the submitted jobs, you can use glibc job status command. And to obtain output of the job, you can use glibc job output. And if you want to cancel a number of jobs, you can also use glibc job cancel command. And here is the example of the submit command. As you can see here, hello world node. The world.gdr is a job description language example. Example one is a file that stores the job ID. It is very useful if you submit many number of jobs, because to manage which job ID is used is difficult. And here is the result of the submitted jobs. The line starts with the HTTPS is the your property. When you want to monitor these jobs, you should pass this line to command or the file instead of it. And here you can monitor the job status with the passing a file that stores the job ID. And the final one is the show that your job is completed successfully. And here, getting job result, glibc job submit, glibc job output command will get the result of the jobs that submitted to grid computing. If your job is being completed successfully, you can obtain the results. And here is the example. Actually, there are many number of commands in grid computing, but here I want to just a brief introduction of the grid computing commands. And this is all my presentation.
Are the GLAC commands installed at CERN on LX Plus?
You are right. After there are many numbers.
I don't think these GVAC commands are on Linux, sir.
Sorry.
Are these GVAC commands installed on Linux Plus, sir?
Yeah. These commands can also be used, but in certain sites there are some tools that means a number of shells. I mean that in the certain sites you are required to manage a thousand of jobs, for example, and manage thousand of jobs with GLAC command is very difficult. Therefore, for example, CRAP or Gandia, Pitana tools manage this kind of task for you. Similarly, there are some GLAC command for data management, but it is very difficult to manage large amount of data to transfer. Therefore, it requires, for example, Atlas DG2 or for CNS physics is required for the SD site. And that's all. If you interest more information, if you want to learn what grid computing is detailed, you can look grid sites. And WRCT Partners website is also possible. And there are also some tutorial on the our website, but they are mostly prepared in the Turkish. And you can also look at